We have developed a sports physics group. The idea is to improve the performance of the athlete with whom we work. So the one we are going to talk today is Martin Fourcade, who is a B athlete, and so practice both cross-country skiing and shooting. They have a big habit of which wax to use in Europe and United States, but the next Olympic Games will take place in Korea with a kind of different condition of temperature and humidity. And so they were wondering if we could understand how wax works in order to take the more appropriate in Korea.
To do that, we built an experiment. So we order a big fridge container, and inside we can decrease the temperature below zero and until minus 30 degrees centigrade. And then we pull a ski on the snow, and we put a force sensor to measure the force.
There is a product that has been tested and that seems to lower the friction coefficient down to values that are not accessible with the one that you can buy at the moment. We have invited the people who are in charge of the wax in the team of Martin Fourcade in order for them to check this product, to know how to use it, and then to propose to the champion to try it during his training.
So actually, granular material, it really depends on what kind of phase you're talking about. So imagine taking some sand in your hand, and if you pour it out of your hand, it will just flow as a fluid. If it falls on the table, it forms a heap, and that's more like a solid. And then if you throw it in the air, it flies away like a gas. So it really depends on the boundary conditions and the conditions that you're looking at the material. So I brought today a little prop. This is a casted imprint of an experiment we did in the laboratory. So we are looking at granular materials that are different both in size and shape. And if you mix that and release it on an incline, it forms an avalanche because of segregation. The large particles rise and go to the front. Those large particles are also the angular particles, so they create more friction with the bottom. So they slow down, they stop. And the smaller red particles, in this case, push through and form fingers. And that's the granular fingering instability.
You can demonstrate segregation at home if you take a jar of sand and you put a marble inside it and then you shake it. Then you can see that the marble rises to the top. It also appears in breakfast cereal, so if you have a bag of muesli, then when you start it at the start of the week, you have all the nice Brazil nuts at the top. And by the end of the week, you get to the bottom and you have all the horrible dusty bits at the bottom. So that's why it's also known sometimes as the Brazil nuts effect.
I use an experimental technique that is based on photoelasticity. This is a property of some materials, so that when you stress them, they change refractive index. So they change the way in which light is transferred through them, which means that if you look at them in the right setup, then the only light that comes through that setup is that which has been affected by the forces and the photoelastic response of the material. So in my experiment, I create an avalanche of these photoelastic discs, and as they fall, I see them as dark circles with bright patterns in the middle. And I can relate those bright light patterns to the forces. So I can measure forces from the light that I see, and that's pretty cool, yeah.
A lot of people have seen the YouTube videos of bubbles freezing, but no one's ever really studied that. So we decided to actually study the physics of it and freeze bubbles in a controlled environment.
In Virginia Tech, we have actually kind of what can freeze it. And the temperature inside of that freezer was minus 20 C. That was so cold. I don't know if someone can do that, but that was so fun, you know?
When you freeze a bubble in uniform temperature conditions, like in a freezer, you can turn a bubble into a snow globe. And why this happens is if you put the bubble on a block of ice, the ice will initially grow on the bottom part of the bubble, but as liquid freezes into ice, you are depositing heat into the surrounding liquid. And because a bubble is so thin, it can't spread that heat around. And so all the heat from the freeze front is getting trapped in the bottom of the bubble. And that creates a flow from the hot bottom to the cold top of the bubble. And it rips the ice crystals off with it and takes them along for the ride. And so you have this flurry of snow crystals just kind of all flowing around the bubble like crazy. And it looks like a snow globe, literally. And it's very beautiful. Very cheap Christmas present to market.